State Finance Minister Sudhir Mungandiwar to table a white paper on outstanding dues on tax and non-tax revenues received by the state. Government is serious on Ambedkar Bhavan demolition issue. Anticipatory bail to the accused to be challenged by the state, says Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis. Thank you, Munmun. Hi and welcome to Metro Scan from Mumbai. I'm Shama Mishra. Let's see the news in detail. State Finance Minister Sudhir Mungandiwar today informed that a white paper will be tabled in the next session of the State Assembly on outstanding dues on tax and non-tax revenue received by the state. He further informed that due to various reasons, the outstanding dues past 10 to 12 years have amounted 62,907 crore 91 lakh rupees. State Transport Minister Divakar Raute stated that in order to ensure safety and disciplined traffic rules, petrol will not be provided at petrol pumps to commuters without helmets. Eknath Shinde, PWD Minister, informed that in the coming 6 months, e-toll facility will be provided in the state. Meanwhile, Social Justice Minister Rajkumar Badole spoke on the Navi Mumbai honour killing case, stating that such crimes are very heinous and such incidents can be prevented.
Nerud mein jo ghatna ghati hai, nishchit hai ye atyant kleshdayak aisi ghatna hai. तो उनको माननीय मुख्यमंत्री ने त्वरित निलंबित किया, लेकिन इस प्रकार से अगर किसी प्रकार की अगर कहीं पे ऐसी तकरार आती है तो निश्चित उसमें जल्दी से जल्दी कार्यवाही होनी चाहिए। और इसका मुझे लगता है कि जिन लोगों ने इसमें अपराध किया तो उन अपराधियों को जल्दी से जल्दी शिक्षा मिलने के लिए निश्चित ही फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट या फिर इसमें ये प्रकरण ये करा के जो अपराधी है उसको जल्दी कार्यवाही होनी चाहिए।
State Education Minister Vinod Tawde informed in the assembly that secondary and higher secondary schools which are eligible for grants will be provided grants before the Ganesh Chaturthi. Talking on safety and security for girl students, Tawde informed that schools in rural areas will be put under the CCTV surveillance. In addition, state will also impart adolescent health education to girls, and state is considering to form a committee for the same. State Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis today reiterated its commitment to uplift Dalits by several schemes and programs. Talking to media during monsoon session of State Assembly, Fadnavis refuted opposition's allegation that the government is not serious about Dalit concerns. He was reacting on the current outcry over the Ambedkar Bhavan in Dadar, allegedly by the trust. On June 25th, sprawling structure at Dadar, from where Bharat Ratna Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar launched his political movement, was demolished. This incident triggered a wide protest in across the state, and the issue was also aggressively raised in the parliament.
ट्रस्ट का मामला था जिस ट्रस्ट के लोगों ने प्राइवेटली इसको गिराने का प्रयास किया, लेकिन राज्य सरकार ने इसमें प्रमुखता से भूमिका ली है और हम ये मानते हैं कि बुद्धभूषण प्रेस जो है ये एक प्रकार से हमारे राष्ट्र की धरोहर है और इसलिए हम लोग अंबेडकर परिवार से भी चर्चा कर रहे हैं। चर्चा करके उसको हेरिटेज में अगर हम लोग ले पाए तो हेरिटेज में लेकर, और हमने ये भी कहा है कि जो इसका नुकसान हुआ है तो सरकार की ओर से खुद सरकार उसको बना कर देगी, ऐसा हमने निर्णय लिया है। जो दीवार वगैरह गिरी है और उसका जो रेस्टोरेशन करना है तो उस रेस्टोरेशन कंप्लीट राज्य सरकार की ओर से हम करेंगे। और उसके आगे जाकर मैंने तो ये भी कहा है कि जो बाकी जो इमारत है जिसको अम्बेडकर भवन कहा जाता है, उस अम्बेडकर भवन को अगर ये सारे परिवार और सारे लोग मिलकर उसकी एक संकल्प चित्र को मान्यता देते हैं तो इस विवाद से बाहर निकलने के लिए न ट्रस्ट उसको तैयार करे न कोई दूसरा तैयार करे, सरकार उसको बांध कर देगी।
Protests continue in parts of Ahmednagar district and few other pockets of the state over gruesome gang rape and murder of minor girl last week in Koppadi village. In Solapur, people took part in the protest rally, which was jointly joined by the large number of women demanding safety and security. Shiv Sena, Congress Party, NCP and other parties held protests in Solapur and demanded the government to ensure fearless environment for women. Bahujan Samaj Party workers today staged a protest in Solapur district condemning over the derogatory remarks made by the BJP leader Daya Shankar Singh against BSP chief Mayawati, as well as the recent assault on Dalit family in Gujarat. Four protesters shaved off their hair as a mark of protest under the guidance of BSP Solapur corporator Anand Chandan Shive. Likewise, a protest rally was also carried out at Nagpur district, raising slogans against Daya Shankar Singh. Textile Commissioner Kavita Gupta today highlighted various steps taken by the government for doing business in easier manner in the textile industry. Speaking at a press conference, she said that ease of doing business, transparency and various other aspects will play an important role in promoting trade and business. She further said that this department needs to tune in with the current technology in the textile sector.
Public aware of the various steps being taken by the government for doing business in a easier manner. So the objective is to tell the and inform the public what are the steps which have already been taken by the government towards ease of doing business and what are the steps which the government would also be taking in future for ease of doing business. We require to improve on various kind of methods of seeing how we can improve our logistics, how we can improve on our credit facilities, how we can improve upgrade our technology and have more efficient technology and state-of-art machinery.
The Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation decided to withdraw the 20% water cut in the city, which was imposed in last August, as the state has been receiving incessant and heavy rainfall in catchment areas over the reservoirs over the last 2 weeks. The announcement was made in the meeting of BMC's standing committee, which will be implemented from today, giving some relief to Mumbaikars. The Seven Lakes, which supplies water to Mumbai, has 55% water stock collected, and so the decision to take back water cut has been taken. That's it then in this edition of Metro Scan from Mumbai. We'll be back tomorrow.